Good morning. Well, I love fixing things that are broken, but through the years I've nurtured a surprisingly deep talent for breaking things that don't need to be fixed. Today I was midway through a simple brake light change in our 2015 Subaru Forester when I ran into a complication that disabled the car enough to lock up the transmission shift lever and throw a BLS code C1531. This misadventure exposes an interesting alternate cause for a brake light trouble code. And the video highlights some easy solutions you might reach for if you find your Subaru won't shift out of park and you want to avoid a tow. I hope you come along. To get at this bulb, undo these two nuts here, they're 10 millimeter. Now you'll see this in a second, but there are a couple of prongs in here, and then there's one little plastic clip here and the whole thing pulls backwards. And I've found the easiest way to do this is to pull it back like so. Here's a better view. You've got these two studs here that slide into these little plastic grommets, and then you've got this solid one that slides in down here. So this is the original bulb. It's a 5-watt bulb, and I went to the parts store asking for a replacement, and this is the one they sold me. This was picked out by a professional, and I didn't even notice that they'd actually picked out the wrong one. This is a 23-watt bulb compared to the 5-watt bulb that is OEM. Do you think that's going to be a problem? What do you think happened next? Now, when I installed this incorrect bulb into the fitting, it was a loose connection and the light flickered. But even though my instinct was the connector was bad because of excessive heat previously, I couldn't get it to fit any better. Worse yet, when I finally decided the bulb had to be wrong, in fading light when trying to move the vehicle out from under the garage door, it wouldn't shift out of park. And I got a new ABS and traction control light on the dash. Then I did a full vehicle scan and I came up with code C1531, BLS stuck off, which means the computer has found discordance between the pressure it measures when you put your foot on the brake and the electrical brake signal. Somehow the computer wasn't getting confirmation that the brake light switch was working, and I verified that on live data with the scan tool. Now none of the three brake lights are working. So at that point I decided to erase the code to see if it'd come back, and indeed it's a hard fault, it comes back right away. So then I decided to go and check a wiring diagram, and the worst of it was I had to sheepishly go into the house and confess to my wife that I'd broken her car and I wasn't sure when it was going to be fixed. It was a frosty night. So I'll show you the pattern I had last night. Started up and we got an ABS light and a hill traction light. And then we'll get a signal up here. ABS needs to be checked and vehicle dynamic control system. So what's going on? Now the other thing is I can't get it out of drive, it's locked. So to fix that, the problem last night was that I was parked underneath my garage door opener and I needed to close the garage door. And so I popped this little tab open and used a long screwdriver, this one here, and you press down while you're holding your foot on the brake. And then, press down while holding your foot on the brake, and then you can get it into drive. Now two things came immediately to mind. First, I was using a long screwdriver to press the brake pedal to test the lights, and I wondered if I'd accidentally touched or dislocated the sensor underneath. Let me show you where this brake light switch is. This was replaced on a recall a year ago. So even though the code is, that's it right there, even though the code is suggesting there's a problem with the brake light switch, in fact, it may be a simpler solution. Now let's spend a little time on the wiring diagram. Here's the stoplight brake switch we looked at a moment ago, attached to the brake pedal. It's a double pull, single throw switch. Here's the fuse box at the driver's left knee, and here's the brown wire that leads in parallel to the three brake lights at the back of the car, and then from there to ground. Power for the rear side lights comes via two fuses, fuse 14 and fuse 8. Now let's follow fuse 8 up to the input side of the stoplight switch. Notice that when you press the brake, this normally open switch closes, sending voltage to those three brake lights. So if I caused a short when I put the wrong bulb on the connector and then pressed on the brake pedal, which fuse would blow? So the two fuses we want to focus on are fuse 14 and 8. This is 14. 14 is good. And then 8, hot on one side, nothing on the other. Let's get that one out of there. It's a bit hard to tell whether it's blown just on looking at it, so I'm going to test it definitively. And we've got huge resistance, so this fuse is blown. Okay, so just replacing the fuse fixed the problem. And you can see why that happened just based on what I did with the wrong bulb. Ironically, my access to a scan tool actually made the diagnosis more difficult because it pointed towards a break switch error where, in actual fact, it was just a transient short from the bulb. I would have been a lot faster just by following old school instincts. In my view, the most noteworthy thing about this is that the engineers decided to disable the vehicle in the setting of a transient short of the brake light circuit. And you can see why they do that after looking at the circuit drawing. The brake light switch is inherently tied to the ABS and the traction control system, and they're all dependent on each other. So you've got this classic dilemma, this trade-off between function and form, between complexity and durability. In any case, if you do own a Subaru, it's probably worthwhile having a long screwdriver or something long and pokey to get yourself out of trouble and maybe bring along a few extra fuses as well. Thanks for watching.